Newmarch Nursing Home near Penrith has been hit with more tragedy, a fourth person dying of coronavirus. As we go to air tonight, family members of residents are in a conference call with an Anglicare official demanding answers on what will be done.
Another protest at the gates of Newmarch House Nursing Home, and then the tragic news of another death. A 79-year-old woman, the fourth resident to pass away in less than a week.
Very worried, very concerned.
Louise Payne's mother is one of 28 residents still inside the home suffering coronavirus, and she's trying to stay positive.
She's strong, she's a tough woman, but, you know, she is 89.
The growing death toll and the earlier stories of neglect led to this damning admission on the Today Show from the minister in charge.
Oh, I'd be very distressed if I had a relative in there, Carl.
The federal government was forced into action yesterday, deploying an emergency response team to deal with a lack of staff and care.
The report that I received last night was that we are very close to being back to the staffing levels that we want.
But a press release this afternoon from Anglicare suggested otherwise. The staff shortage at Anglicare Newmarch House continued yesterday, with at least one third of the staffing needs still to be met. And with Newmarch in lockdown and dealing with more death, the Premier was pushing the National Cabinet's decision to begin lifting restrictions on aged care facilities.
The Prime Minister made that very clear. His intent is to make sure that loved ones have access to each other, and that's certainly our intent.
But just the thought of opening the doors sent a shudder through the industry.
Anywhere between 20% to 50% of national death tolls around the globe are residents in aged care facilities.
On the northern beaches, this village and nursing home has been renamed Fortress Alambie, and no one is going in.
The reason we're in lockdown is because we want to save lives.
The government has been criticised for sending mixed messages when it comes to returning children safely back to school. Now they're being accused of making the same mistake with the elderly, who are of course most at risk from the coronavirus.
And the industry warns we will pay a heavy price if they get it wrong.
We do not want that to occur, and that's why lockdown and restricted access must continue for a bit longer.
Damien Ryan, 9 News.